pitching is to put that ball out of your hand in the strike zone, and then it ends up falling.
How do you train for pitch recognition? I mean, that's a new technology for that now. Virtual reality actually is a new thing that is going to be the next big thing in baseball. And batters are actually putting on the goggles, the virtual reality goggles, and looking at pitches coming at them while they try to react and swing and recognize spin.
I think I told you this story. I don't know if you heard of it. That was Burks one day. Really good hitter. He ended up as Cleveland. I went down to the cage, and I was close to him. Looking over, and the fly went up the middle, graded back. This continues to do what he's done all of June.
Kiki!
Continue to swing the bat well. He's not going to throw right into your living room. It's going to end up right at the middle. Swing.
Kiko! Kiko!
Check the pitch when they were tennis balls. So I started leaving. I'm like, Evans, what are you doing? He said, I look at this ball. And I looked at it. And it had a red number written on it. And he had literally trained himself. This thing was throwing hard, too, where he could actually pick up numbers, written on a tennis ball. So it is amazing what your eyes and you can teach yourself to do.
Yeah.
Judge it a short ground ball right in the first inning.
Forget that Maven, I mean, he is a veteran player and he has been through a World Series. Because I'm talking to a lot of the Astros before the game. He was on that World Series team for them.
It's not through the first. As you mentioned, it's not what you're playing against. I mean, so I like all these guys, but these guys are my brothers. So these are the guys I'm playing with. I hope they come to work every day as Judge goes down. 2-1.
Can't get enough of those shots, huh, Cody?
He's still getting about 9 holes in right now, Paul.
Yeah, better keep the ball in play and keep going.
Kiko! Kiko! Kiko!
Is there such a thing, you had that sort with the Reds, Paul. And you came over to the Yankees and they brought into your hitting style. And after kind of butting your head in Cincinnati with Lou wanting to pull the ball, I mean, not that it's exactly the same, but Maven talks about that, about feeling, turning it loose, feeling freer here for the first time.
So much different.
Gone.
Now, and there's a strike to Royce. right to your point, well, that was a changeup at 82 miles an hour. With that approach that you described, you're right on time to speed up your bad head and just launch.
By staying on it, I mean, you don't pull off of it. It's all in the front hip to me. A lot of batting instructors think it's the front shoulder. If you keep that front hip in there, you know, everything else will follow. Michael, you know how to do it? Is that a home run?
Right.
Take it home.
Yeah,
I got the call.
This is two for two.
Deal.
Now, maybe Hawk Sanchez will watch. He starts to left.
Yeah, probably Gary probably stepped on his foot. You talk those spikes, sometimes they help you stop. Sometimes they hurt when people step on you, too. 481 feet before the longest home run.